All right, I just spent forever filming because I'm going out of town. And I just realized, oh, I'm going out of town. I should film some videos. But I actually have the weekend to myself. Both my roommates are camping, and I haven't actually been in my own space without having to be, like, nervous about filming in forever. So it's been nice. And I decided I think I might do just my own, like, mini readathon this weekend and film that for you guys. And it's also, like, I like doing the challenge vlog thing, so we'll see what happens. I have, like, a couple things that are exciting this weekend that might be worth, like, filming. I'm, like, I have so many books around me, and my face is all red. So much smiling in the warm light. But I have lots of books I want to read, because it's the end of the Olympics Readathon, and I want to read all the things. And I don't know what possessed me, but let's talk about the things I want to read. First of all, I'm still working on Memories of Ice. I don't plan on finishing it, but I'm that far, and I need to make at least some good headway. I'd like to read, like, two chapters this evening, if I could do that. If for sure one. If I could do one, that'd be great. I'm starting part four. What's it called even? It's called Memories of Ice. That's the name of the book. So we will see. I would like to try and do that, but I've also been reading Dark Matter, which was completely on a whim. I don't think I'm on that chapter anymore because I found the audiobook when I was on my walk home. My library just kind of had it. I'm this far in. I would like to finish this today. I'm pretty sure I could because I have nothing else to do. It's like 4:30 p.m. when I'm like filming this right now. So I'd like to finish this today, especially since I'm a little over halfway and I have the audiobook so I can do this while running errands and doing chores, etc. My thoughts so far is that, I don't know, I think I've been burned by a lot of books recently where people are like, go in blind. And I'm like, okay, will do. Like, I mean, I typically do, right? Like, I don't typically learn that much about a book before I read it, but I'm also not actively avoiding it. In this book is a sci-fi thriller, and I get thrillers, you don't want to know the twist, but like it's I mean, maybe I'm missing something, there's another half the book to go, but it's not like that twisty. I don't know, and that happened with me in Never Let Me Go, where I'm like, well, if you know sci-fi, this isn't that hard to parse out. And also, this main character is, for how smart he's supposed to be, is kind of dumb. Like, he's making some choices. And I need to look up what Blake Crouch's relationship is with physics, because I don't have issues with the sci-fi-ness of it. Like, I don't care about the science fiction elements and what he's doing with the sci-fi element in here. But, like, there's a lot of discussion on, like, academia and being a researcher. And I think some of it holds true. But also, like, some of it's also just not how, like, science works for, like, the average individual in academia. And it's just, it's interesting. I'm not hating the book. I've read Recursion. It's definitely what I expected after reading Recursion. But it's like, lately I've been reading a lot of like action, thriller, sci-fi that I would have just preferred to have seen the movie. So if I didn't have this readathon and if I didn't have like the book club for shelf space, I maybe wouldn't keep going with this. I don't know. It's not an unenjoyable time. It's just like, also like not that amazing either. I don't know. So that's happening. This next one I definitely am hoping to read tonight. That's The Starlight Barking. It's a kid's book. It's like 110 pages. This will take me like an hour. It's the sequel to The 100 Wild Dalmatians. It's for my Patreon book club. Ooh, it has pictures. I didn't know this had pictures. That's exciting. Oh, there's so many pictures. This is very exciting to me. So I need to read that before tomorrow, because tomorrow we have book club. So these are the two that I want to finish tonight. I want to get a good chunk of this done. Other things I would be hoping to read this weekend, besides continuing Memories of Ice, is I just picked this up from the library yesterday. It is called Driftwood by Mary Brennan, who is the author, well, one of the authors of The Mask of Mirrors and the Natural History of Dragons book, which I still haven't read. But I was just like at the library and I saw it and I was like, ooh, novella. Ooh, this also has art. Oh, it's so exciting. But I really liked The Mask of Mirrors. My mom's been writing The History of Dragons or whatever it's called. So I don't know. I just thought this would be a fun like novella to read this weekend if I was like really in a reading mood and feeling it. And I really like the cover. So I think it might put it in my Aphrodite slot. It depends. Might also work for Hermes based off the back of the book. We'll find out. And then the last one I don't think I'll finish this weekend, but that I'm working on, that's like my Kindle read, is The Pattern Master. And the fourth book, fifth, it's the fourth book, but it's the fifth book. It's also the first book. I can't talk about this series in any logical way. The first public book, but the last chronological book in the Patternist series, Pattern Master. I've only read the first, like, a prologue and part of the chapter. I could see this being a very confusing book without any of the books that I've read before it, because it is, like, one of those drops-you-in-the-middle stories where it's a completely, like, unrealistic world sort of thing. So those are all of the things, and maybe by the end of this vlog I'll have finished these three and a lot of this. That'd be great. That'd be really good. I mainly just want to get all the points for my team. That's what I want to do. And also, like, I rarely have the apartment to myself, so I, like, don't feel, like, any need to socialize with my roommates. Not that I dislike socializing with them. It's fun watching TV and, like, you know, just chatting, but I can just stay up as late as I want, read as long as I want. I say that, but I'm, like, 28, and I'll probably be in bed by, like, 11, so we'll see what happens.
Thought I would update you guys with this beautiful fuzz. So it's been 4 hours since I last checked in, and I'm almost done with what I wanted to read with Memories of Ice. I only have, like, 10 pages left, and that would be both the chapters that I wanted to do. Ooh, we are in the point where, like, I just get to learn all the things. It's so good. I'm gonna just focus you on the cat, though, because we all know that's why you're here. It's for the fuzz. Yes. I've also been listening to Dark Matter while I've done, like, laundry and gotten food and all of those things. And it's fine. It's perfectly fine. Like, I foresee this being a solid 3-star read, assuming it doesn't make me more annoyed or angry than I already am, like, if I stay at my current level. But if it does annoy me more, it might become a 2.5. We shall see. It's just, like, leaned into some tropes that I get tired of, which is not its fault per se, but from an enjoyment standpoint, I don't love. And then, like, I feel like it's trying to be hard sci-fi, and that's the only reason I'm upset about some inconsistencies in the sci-fi that's been around. But it's also something I can, like, forgive. It's just, it feels more fun if I think of it as, like, a magical realism thriller, which I know is such a weird thing to say, but it, like, makes it make more sense to me. It is time. And also, look at the art! There's so much art in this book. The Great Swoosh. I have no expectations for this one, but I'm hoping to have a great time. More art! Oh, there's so many pictures. I'm very excited.
Okay, it's, like, 10:30 now, and as predicted, I am already turning into a pumpkin, because I'm an old lady who likes sleep. But, oh, hey, Delilah. You guys don't see her. Here she is, my little baby. And I don't think you guys have seen my glasses. These are my new glasses. I really love them. But I have made it 50 pages into The Starlight Parking. This was published in 1967. And it's mostly just a fun, wacky, fantastical time. Like, nothing needs to be taken seriously. It's wacky. But there's also, like, some slight thematic things that I'm like, I don't like that. Like, it's small stuff, like a little bit of fat phobia. There's a little bit of, like, self-imposed eugenics of the dogs. And then obviously dog breed comes into it. And it's just a little weird in those regards. But, like, it's mostly meant as, like, a story about doggos who have to deal with the fact that everything but doggos are asleep and the world weird and magical all of a sudden. I highly recommend watching Judith's video and not reading the book. I mean, the book's fine. I mean, I guess if you really want to, go ahead and read it, especially if you like children's literature and stuff. But I had way more fun watching Judith's video than I have been reading this, but also I just don't read children's literature. I keep thinking it should go by faster, but honestly, I guess I read children's literature just as quickly as I read adult literature. So I might try and read like 20, 30 more pages of this tonight before bed. I'll for sure finish it before book club tomorrow. And now I am this far into Dark Matter. I don't have any more updates since I last checked in. This was just, I was using the audiobook to get through this chunk from like 50% till 75%. I used the audiobook, which was good. I think audiobooks are really good for me if, like, it's an action-packed book in first person, which this is. Because physically reading that has just been not my thing for a really long time. I don't know why, but, like, first person, fast-paced book hasn't worked in my brain physically reading for a while. I think part of that's just, like, a preference of, like, media and stuff like that.
But I will say, so I've been pretty, like, lukewarm on the book. Just, I don't know, it's just not doing much for me. It's mostly, like, it's not, like, the book's bad, but I just don't think the book's anything special. And I've been slowly realizing that, like, plot-driven stories that are, like, this fast-paced, I prefer movies. But a thing happened that I thought was really interesting that I didn't expect, and I have no clue how it will be resolved. So now I have, like, an intriguing thing that I'm interested in, and I think there's, like, what page am I on? I'm, like, 266, and the whole book is, like, 340. So I have less than 100 pages. So I don't know if I'll finish either of these tonight before, like, my brain goes sleep, but I'd like to. And if not, I'll for sure finish both tomorrow. And then I can maybe start that Mary Brennan novella because it's calling to me. It looks really pretty. I have no clue if I'll like it. I got it just purely off of her writing style in The Mask of Mirrors, which honestly, I don't even know if The Mask of Mirrors is her writing style, right? That was two authors, but I'm hopeful. So I'm going to go read some things with the fuzz. My cats are very needy because I'm the only one here and they're used to being loved by all the people. All right, so it is the next day. It's, I think, noonish. I just had lunch and I finished two of the things, although I didn't finish them last night because I wasn't feeling it, but I finished Starlight Barking, which good thing because book club's in like 30 minutes. And I surprisingly have a lot of things I want to talk about with this one. It is such a time capsule. Written in 1967, it comes with all of the problematic baggage. I mean, it's not horrible, but like, I mean, if it was published today, I'd be like, no. Like, there's just some stuff in here that I'm like, that shouldn't be in your kid's book. It's not, like I said, it's not egregious, but it's definitely of its time, especially with like the Cold War themes and everything like that. And it's so fantastical. And I pretty much from the beginning is like, yes, 101 Dalmatians happened. Everyone's happy, and now here's this crazy plot where everyone's asleep, but the dogs, and the dogs have to, like, figure things out for a day. I mean, I think it accomplishes its goals. It was a fun time. I knew what I was in for because I watched Judith's video beforehand, so I'm curious to see how this book club goes. My patrons are the best because they're willing to do fun things like this. Like, they all voted for this, so we have a fun time over there. I also finished Dark Matter, and I listened to the second half, although I did like an immersion read for the last like 30 pages because I wanted to finish it, but like I liked listening to the audiobook, but if I don't stare at something while I listen to things, or if I'm not doing a meaningless task, my mind just wanders. I'm sure a lot of you out there can relate to that. So this might become a 3.5 instead of a 3. I can't decide. The ending really did a lot of stuff that I liked. I mean, it made the character more interesting to me. Like, I liked him a lot more by the end based off just decisions he made and the circumstances he was thrown in. And, like, I legit didn't know what the solution to the problem introduced would be, and so I was really happy with that. I do think it's a little melodramatic in some of its theming. Like, it's just, I don't know, it's just very, I don't want to, it's just, there are many paths you can take in life, and it really harps on that theme a lot, and I just think it does it in kind of a melodramatic way for my tastes. But that's a taste thing. I don't think it did anything wrong. I don't think it's anything like mind-bending or fantastic. I'm probably actually going to make a review for this because I actually do have a lot of thoughts and like can coherently probably say in a review video, spoiler-free, what did and didn't work for me. So it's, you know, I knew what I was getting into because I had read Recursion, and I'm glad I read this so I can see everyone's thoughts at the book club for Shelf Space tomorrow. So that happened. So no regrets, and I feel accomplished. So that means I have a new audiobook for today. But before that, I want to read the next chapter of this afternoon. It's like 60 pages, so that's going to take me a few hours. But things are like, I think I've been told, converging. Like, that's what you call the end of a Malazenberg book, is like a convergence instead of like a Sanderlanch or whatever people call things. And things are happening. Like, yesterday when I was reading the sections, I was like not bored at all. Like, this is a book that's very similar to me in like my Lord of the Rings experience, where like when a Lord of the Rings chapter got me, it got me, and when I was bored, I was bored. And that's similar here, although there's a lot of, this is a lot more complex, it's a lot denser than Lord of the Rings. So I'm excited to see what happens in this next chapter, because we're in the end game. Like, we're getting there, so I'm excited to see what's happening. And then last night, I didn't finish the other books because I didn't really want to read them because they were kind of like fine, but they were chores, right? So I picked up Driftwood, which I told you guys I picked up at the library. And guys, Mary Brennan might be like a favorite author.
Like, I don't know yet. It's only my second work by this author, and the first one was like a partnership with another author, so who knows. I still need to read the Lady of Trent memoirs. It's the one with the dragons. This, I mean, I am only at the beginning, but the premise is all these worlds go to die at Drift World, and I'm loving that. That world building has been fantastic in the short amount of time I've been here. The story style and like narrative structure is like really cool. Like, it already has like some mixed media elements. We have different narrative framing, and it's so fun so far. I might go to the bookstore later and see if they have a physical copy for me to buy, because I might need this for my collection. Because also this cover, right? Is this cover not stunning? So that's a thing I'm working on. That's like my pure pleasure read right now. And my audiobook I might pick up on my walk to the bookstore is Book of Salt, which was recommended to me by Audrey at Perpetual Pages. Well, not to me specifically. They talked about it in a wrap up, and I'm like, ooh, that sounds interesting. And it'll work for Demeter because it has food on the cover. So those are my thoughts for today and what I'm hoping to do. And I'm excited because book club's about to happen. So let's see what people have to say about Starlight Barking.
So it is evening. The cats have been fed. I have done all the things I planned to do today. Book club went well. We all had very similar, interesting thoughts. It was a great time. I have read a chunk of this tonight, and I've run out of steam, but it's been really good. It's just, I need to be more awake. And it's normally more my morning or afternoon read, not my evening read, because of like my brain. So I'm going to definitely focus on reading the pages I want to read of this tomorrow morning. But now for the rest of the evening, we are going to read Driftwood. Isn't that right, Pootow? Isn't that right, Fuzz? Isn't that right? They're all missing, all the people. They normally aren't hanging out with me, even though they're my cats. They like Ryan a lot more than me for some reason. Also, if you're hearing noises, Delilah is having her dinner on the other side of the room, being a good kitty cat. So yeah, we're going to read Drift World. And I also have Pattern Master on the Kindle, so I can always switch to that if I want a sci-fi and change of pace. And I always have plenty of other things on the Kindle. The goal is to read tonight. Whatever puts me in the mood to read, I am going to pick it up. Good morning. I spent most of my night reading Driftwood. It's been really great. When I finish it, I'll like really tell you guys about my thoughts, but there's so much of this story that was just pretty much made for me. So that's what I want to work on this morning. And I also want to get to Memories of Ice. I want to read like 30 to 40 pages. I have 150 pages left and 4 days to read it. Obviously, if the story takes me away, all I want to do is read that. But then I have Pattern Master on deck. So these are my reading plans for the day. It'd be fantastic if I could finish Driftwood, which I don't foresee there being a problem, and Pattern Master, in which I think I only have 3 or so hours left if I have nothing else to do today. But I do want to prepare my video for tomorrow, maybe edit my Wednesday video, and the boys come back later. So I'll probably end the vlog this afternoon, so then it's like a 48-hour reading vlog, and we'll see what I've accomplished, and anything else I've started, you'll just have to find out in the wrap-up. But good morning. This is what my hair does at night. It could be worse. I've honestly woken up to worse. But I just figured while I was sitting here having my breakfast, I would check in. Ugh, the humidity is coming and it's not leaving for days. And we're gonna wrap up the vlog here because the men have returned from their camping trip. And honestly, I have finished things and it seems like a good place to wrap it up. So everything else, I'll talk about what I'm still reading, and you'll have to see in the wrap up that comes out hopefully Monday or Wednesday next week what's going on. But I just finished Driftwood this morning. Oh goodness. I need to get myself a copy. This is just very much an Angela book. I don't think I've really gone into detail about why this is an Angela book. And now that I'm finished, it's a good thing I finished too, because it's definitely like, it's not a book that's going to work for everyone, or a novella, or whatever you will call it. So this is a place where all worlds go after their apocalypses to die. Kind of a morbid thought, right? And we're following these people. We're not even following anyone. What's happening is there's this character, Last, who is the last of his kind, last of his world. He's an immortal. He's a guide. He's kind of a legend because of things. And one day, he's no longer around. People think he might be dead. Maybe he went somewhere else. Regardless, this triggers kind of this whole memorial service where people start telling their stories about their interactions with Last, and through that, their interactions in Driftwood, which is such a cool idea. And then, as I was just enjoying it on a story level, it thematically resonates with me so much right now. Like, in my third heat wave of summer, when in Boston, heat waves don't normally start till July, and mid-July at that, like, it's way too early for this. I feel like I'm in an apocalypse sometimes, right? Like, it's not been an easy couple years, and it's always been getting hotter and hotter, etc. To have a story that's about how you live after the world ends, or as your world gets torn down, what does it mean to live and still have hope, and what do you hold on to? I really, really, really found it cathartic, and just, like, great, like, folklore storyteller vibes, which, again, my thing. So great world building intrigue, great storyteller vibes. I really like Last as, like, an intriguing, legendary, charismatic person. And I thematically really liked the messages. Now, the ending is a little different, but I think I liked it because of how it was set up and the narrative framing is unique. But I really liked it, and I think I need to get a copy. So this was a very good cover borrow from the library. So I finished that. I still need to read Memories of Ice, which I have over here, but I don't have any more new thoughts, and I want to read The Pattern Master, and I did start The Book of Salt. I don't know much about it. I'm only 12% of the way in. It's a historical fiction. I now know I'm in France. I know it's the 20s, right before the Great Depression, and it's a Vietnamese man who wants to cook, and I think he's trying to get a job at these Americans' place in France. It's going to be really interesting because I don't know much at all about this time period in this location and the boundaries of French and America and Vietnam. So I'm going to learn a lot there, but I also really like the voice of our main character because it feels like we're mostly in their head and looking at their experiences as a Vietnamese person here in France in the 20s. So we'll see what happens. That audiobook is something I'd love to finish before the readathon because it would work for Demeter, but even if it goes over, I'm having a good time. And so yeah, this weekend's little readathon, I finished these three things. Not that you can see them all with the spines like that. So I'm pretty happy with that. It was pretty productive. And that's it for this one. Let me know if you've read any of these. Leave a world emoji for Driftwood because, like, that was the winner of the weekend. Like, everything else has been fine. I had great discussions on Starlight Barking. Dark Matter had a great book club I was just watching. But, like, Driftwood was the story that had me excited to read this weekend. It was just right place, right time. Barry Brennan's definitely an author where I need to read a lot more of her works. I have her Dragon book on my shelf, and I'm going to have to up that on the TBR. But otherwise, like if you liked it, subscribe if you want to, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!